the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. My brothers and sisters, along with our Archbishop Emeritus Robert Carlson, our Auxiliary Bishop Mark Rivetuso, our Auxiliary Bishop Emeritus Bishop Robert Herman, I welcome you to the Cathedral Basilica of St. Louis on this glorious day. As a matter of fact, I couldn't believe it's St. Louis with the beautiful weather, low humidity. God is certainly smiling upon all of us. As we will unite in prayer for Deacon Eugene Schaefer and Deacon Donald Morris, it is a joy to welcome them and their families, fellow parishioners, brother priests and deacons, women and men in consecrated life, our seminary faculty members, brother seminarians, and all who have helped and encouraged our brothers to come to this joyous day. I welcome the rectors of our two seminaries who are represented here by our ordinance, Father James Mason from Kenrick Glennon and Father Brian Kiley from Pope St. John the 23rd Seminary in Weston, Massachusetts. Thank you for your prayers and encouragement of Deacon Jean and Deacon Don and your supportive presence here this morning on this very sacred and beautiful day. Gathering together then as God's people, conscious of the call that God gives to each one of us, let us turn now seeking forgiveness for our sins. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord, our God, who in governing your people make use of the ministry of priest, grant a persevering obedience to your will to these deacons of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of the priesthood, so that by their ministry and life, they may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me thus: Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know not how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord answered me, Say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, See, I place my words in your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Mm-hmm. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, since we have this ministry through the mercy shown us, we are not discouraged. Rather, we have renounced shameful hidden things, not acting deceitfully or falsifying the word of God, but by the open declaration of the truth, we commend ourselves to everyone's conscience in the sight of God. For we did not preach ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord, and ourselves as your slaves for the sake of Jesus. For God, who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," has shone in our hearts to bring to light the knowledge of the glory of God on the face of Jesus Christ. But we hold this treasure in earthen vessels, that the surpassing power may be of God and not from us. The word of the Lord.
According to Luke.
Glory to you, O
Lord. The Lord Jesus appointed 72 other disciples whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say peace to this household. If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.'"
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Those who are to be ordained priests come forward. Reverend Mr. Donald Christopher Morris. Reverend Mr. Eugene William Schaefer.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these men, our brothers, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people and upon the recommendation of those concerned with their formation, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and of our Savior Jesus Christ, we choose these, our brothers, for the order of the priesthood.
Thanks be to God.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, our High Priest, today we witness the ever-ancient, yet ever-new rite of the ordination to the priesthood of Deacon Eugene Schaefer and Deacon Donald Morris. This sacred event falls within the celebration of our Easter season. At the vigil of our celebration of the Ascension of the Lord, how appropriate it is that we gather on this day, anticipating the celebration of the Ascension, when Christ told his apostles to go and preach the gospel to all nations. Indeed, through this priesthood ordination, Deacon Donald and Deacon Eugene received that mandate within Christ's body here on earth, to proclaim the gospel of salvation to all those whom they will encounter in their priestly ministry. It is a great privilege in which they will share, as well as a great responsibility. We celebrate the ordination in the context of the three readings which we have just heard from the prophet Jeremiah, St. Paul's second letter to the people of Corinth, and the words of Jesus in St. Luke's Gospel. Each reading enlightens us with a different perspective on priestly ministry. From the interchange between God and Jeremiah that we hear in our first reading, there is a great reluctance on Jeremiah's part to accept the role of prophet. His inexperience, his youth, and his knowledge that the life of a prophet is not an easy one leads Jeremiah to conclude that he is ill-equipped for the task. But God is persistent. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command, you shall speak. Jeremiah is not reluctant out of a rebelliousness against God, but because of his own consciousness of his perceived inabilities. But God assures Jeremiah that grace is with him. God will place the words in Jeremiah's mouth. Ultimately, what does show through is Jeremiah's humility. He stands before God, knowing of his own unworthiness, and acknowledges that he cannot prophesy without the grace of God. This humility is essential to priesthood in order to accompany God's people on their journey, to walk with them, to share their joys and hopes and disappointments and fears. This sense of humility helps us as priests to appreciate and learn from the people whom we serve, for they have much to teach us as we seek to minister to them. Just a personal example. On the tragic day of September 11th, 2001, the parish where I was pastor, we organized a mass for the evening to pray for those who had died in the terrorist attack, as well as to pray for all those first responders who continued rescue operations well into the night. Needless to say, the homily was put together in the midst of the emotions of that day, thinking only of the anger and grief that we faced as a nation. At the end of the Mass, while people left, showing the strain and the tears on their faces, one of the parishioners approached me and asked, "Why didn't you speak of forgiveness for those who committed these acts?" I had to admit to her, "I'm just not there yet. I cannot speak of forgiveness." Her question taught me a great lesson. She was ready to forgive in the horrors of that day. I could not bring myself to that point. How humbling it was to witness her courageous living out of the gospel, which I myself could not yet do. As priests, I'm sure we share many similar moments when the faith of those to whom we minister inspires and humbles us. Let us learn those lessons well, for the Lord is speaking to us through them. St. Paul, in his second letter to the Corinthians, shares with us the true calling of priesthood. On that road to Damascus, encountering the risen Christ, Paul realized that his life was changed forever. As he says, "For we do not preach ourselves, but Jesus Christ is Lord, and ourselves as your slaves for the sake of Jesus." Paul's life was wholly dedicated to the preaching of Jesus crucified and risen. Every missionary journey he undertook was to bring Jesus to others. In our world of rugged individualism and egoism, as priests, we constantly need to examine our own lives, making sure that the self-centeredness so prevalent in our society is not adversely affecting our own motives in ministering to God's people. This can only be done with a solid prayer life, faithfulness to praying the liturgy of the hours, daily celebration of Mass, and availing ourselves to the sacrament of reconciliation. In these ways, we ensure that, like St. Paul, We are preaching Christ crucified and risen solely for the sake of the salvation of God's people. In today's Gospel from St. Luke, we hear of Jesus sending out 72 disciples to go and preach the good news of God's kingdom. To us, from our perspective, it might seem like a harsh mandate, taking nothing for the journey. Yet Jesus shows great wisdom in sending them forth, for they will be equipped only with the word of God. Solely relying on that word, the disciples need nothing else to bring along. In the grace of this ordination, for Donald and Eugene, they are commissioned to bring the word of God to others, along with the sacraments, the powerful presence of God at work among his people. Nothing else is needed. Reliance on God and his grace is given in this sacrament of holy orders. Remember, Donald and Eugene, when you gather men and women into the people of God through baptism, and in the name of Christ and his church, forgive sins in the sacrament of penance, when you comfort the sick with holy oil and celebrate the sacred rites, when you offer praise and thanksgiving through the hours of the day, and pray not only for the people of God, but for the whole world, always remember that you have been taken from among the people and appointed on their behalf in those things that pertain to God. Fulfill, therefore, the ministry of Christ the priest with abiding joy and genuine love. Seek not your own concerns, but those of Jesus Christ. Finally, dear sons, united with your bishop and subject to him, fulfill the office of Christ, head and shepherd of the church, to the best of your ability. Strive to gather the faithful together into one family, so that you may lead them to God the Father through Christ and in the Holy Spirit. Keep always before you the example of the Good Shepherd, who came into this world not to be served, but to serve others, and who came to seek and to save what was lost. Dear sons, before you proceed to the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your resolve to undertake this office. Do you resolve to discharge unfailingly, with the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the office of the priesthood in the presbyteral rank, as trustworthy co-workers with the order of bishops in feeding the Lord's flock? Do you resolve to carry out the ministry of word worthily and wisely in the preaching of the gospel and the teaching of the Catholic faith? Do you resolve to celebrate the mysteries of Christ reverently and faithfully according to the tradition of the church, especially in the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the praise of God and the sanctification of the Christian people? Do you resolve to implore with us the mercy of God for the people entrusted to you, with zeal for the commandment to pray without ceasing? Do you resolve to be united more closely each day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourselves to God for the salvation of all. Donald, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Eugene, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Let us pray, dearly beloved, to God the Almighty Father, that he pour forth heavenly gifts in abundance on these his servants, whom he has chosen for the office of priesthood.
Angel.
graciously hear us.
Hear us, we pray, O Lord our God, and pour out upon these your servants the blessings of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that you may surround with your rich and unfailing gifts those whom we present to your fatherly care for consecration, through Christ our Lord. Draw near, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, author of human dignity and bestower of all graces, through whom all things progress, through whom everything is made firm, who by the power of the Holy Spirit, in order to form a priestly people, establish among them ministers of Christ your Son in various orders. Already in the earlier covenant, there arose offices instituted by mystical rites, so that when you had set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in order and dignity to join them and assist in their work. Thus in the desert, you instilled the spirit of Moses in the minds and the surrender of 70 wise men. With them as helpers, he more easily governed your people. So too, over the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's fullness, that the number of priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a foreshadowing of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, the apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself unblemished to you and made his apostles, who were consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. To them, you added companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation through all the world. Now we pray, O Lord, provide also for our weakness these helpers whom we need for the exercise of the apostolic priesthood. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servants the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they hold the office second in order received from you, O God, and by the example of their manner of life, may they inspire right conduct. May they be trustworthy co-workers with our order, so that by their preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed through the cleansing waters of rebirth and refreshed from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined to us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to them and for the whole world. Thus may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ become your one people, brought to perfection in your kingdom, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. May the Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you will do, imitate what you will celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you will do, imitate what you will celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. O God, who have willed that your priest should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred mystery through the laying on of hands. They are to renew his name, the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, and to nourish them with your word and strengthen them with your sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks. As in exaltation we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, where they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the oblation of our service and that of your whole family, which we make to you. Also for these your servants, whom you have been pleased to raise to the order of priesthood, and in your mercy keep safe your gifts in them, so what they have received by divine commission, they may fulfill with divine assistance. Therefore, Lord, be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high and in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon.
We pray all this through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priest and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. On this great day of rejoicing for the Church of St. Louis, we give thanks to God for the call to our newly ordained priest, to their families who have shared faith with them. We thank Father Donald Morris and Father Eugene Schaefer for their wonderful response to God's call, and we ask God's continued blessings upon them as they seek to serve God's people. Thank God, too, for the great witness of Father Brian Fallon, our vocation director, Father Eddie Voltz, his associate, to Father James Mason and to Father Brian Kiley and their seminary faculties. For us, it's a bittersweet day. Father James Mason, this is perhaps his last appearance as rector here in the Archdiocese of St. Louis. He has served faithfully for 8 years as rector of Kenrick Lennon Seminary. Let us thank him too. Our thanks also to Monsignor Henry Breyer, rector of the Cathedral Basilica, and all of his staff, to all in our music ministry today, who have helped us raise our voices in such a joyful way to praise the Lord during this wonderful ordination ceremony. To the families of our newly ordained priest, we especially acknowledge and thank God for your support, for your sons, for your dad, and for your uncles over these years. First, in sharing the faith with them and encouraging them in their years of seminary formation. It is a privilege to join in the joy that you feel on this day. Again, to Father Eugene Schaefer and to Father Donald Morris, thank you for your witness in accepting the power of the gospel and the responsibilities at your priestly ordination. May God continue to bless you as you seek to serve his people in the image of our Good Shepherd. Now let us ask for God's blessing.
And one brief announcement. For those wishing to take part in reception and first blessings, that will take place in Rosati Kane High School. Please exit to the doors on the east side, so to my left, to your right, and follow the volunteers. Their entrance on Newstead will be open for you. The newly ordained will be over there as soon as they finish their pictures in the All Saints Chapel. Thank you for joining us.
The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of priesthood, we pray. May he make you servants and witnesses in the world to divine charity and truth, and faithful ministers of reconciliation, we pray. And may he make you true shepherds to provide the living bread and word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ, we pray. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And now the moment we've all been waiting for. So Father Donald Morris is assigned as Associate Pastor of Our Lady of Lourdes in Washington. Father Eugene Schaefer will be Associate Pastor at Holy Redeemer in Webster Groves. Congratulations to you both. Thank you. Congratulations.